quick disclaimer, this is not a video on how to pack a chute. This is just record of my journey. And this is the next step. So time to get out the manual.
And we just took it offline and printed it. You can go print yours if you have one and start reading up on it. And we're gonna get to step one.
Hey guys, beautiful day, dry here. It's just time to take the parachute out, let it air out, and repack it. And I hope that it doesn't take too much energy. I've got it set at a really good level where it fits really, really good. It still is a zip pocket for the Nitro 200. It was down here when I was foot launching. We had to move it up and out. I did have it in front. I didn't like that. But because of this line supporting the cage, it can't be down that low because you have a tendency to want to do that right there. So this is the first time we've ever thrown it. So let's see how it goes. All right. Pretty flawless. It didn't catch in the line. It went pretty good. This here is just Velcroed and light Velcro. So it would rip right off the Velcro, I think. Live and learn. Yeah, it would. This would go off the Velcro and of course underneath my arm. After I threw it, once it opened, and then this would deploy up over my back, right there. Sweet.
And there it is after throwing it. Everything went pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Now hopefully I can pack it according to the instructions properly. Another quick modification I'll show you real quick is that fender. I hit a mud puddle the other day. And man, oh man, it sprayed me to something awful. So I made a rear, and I had a little left of some plastic, and put a front on there. Hopefully when the water sprays forward, it doesn't come back in my face, but I haven't had a chance to try it out. So here's a new mod.
Now to inspect the bridle ends, they're covered with a protected, but we put O-rings in there also to keep them from sliding around. Probably tape would be better too, but they look good. With a square, I take it the apex line goes up to the center, but they have these about a third of the way down. They have little loops, and you can tie them all neatly together and then pull the apex line down, and that secures the center. If you have a round one, I believe it, you just tie it right up at the point, right up at the top of the circle. I suppose it's really important not to miss one of these. They're not very visible. Wish they'd done them a different color. That would have been awesome. But you can see each cell where it goes over to. And here must be a corner. I got a Y design cut in there. Just a quick tip if you're doing your own. On a square, on the corners, the tabs, these tabs right here, that you're gonna put your line all the way around on, hook them into a carabiner first. Count them, make sure you got them all. Because if you miss one, you gotta take your line completely back out, and that's, you don't need that wear and tear. And in the four corners, they're a little closer together, so it's easy to miss the corner ones. That's what I just did. So this just came to mind. I'll just clip these on, count them, make sure I got them all, then I'll put my line through. So it's easy to go this one to this one and find it and miss the one on the corner. So there's four of them, they're easy to miss. And that's where I made a mistake. I missed a couple of those. Learn by doing, I like that. put tension on the whole chute and be able to pull all this material down inside with the apex line, from what I understand. You just wonder how you want to gather it though. Should I tie it off here or just let it tension? I'll just let it tension.
Okay, we separated them. The innermost is 1, outermost is 12, and ran them up, and they don't mix with the apex line. 12's on top, 1's on bottom, 12's on top, 1's on bottom. It took a long time to get that folded, and it is hard to get the insides neat where the apex pulls the square down in. So if you want something more simple, round, as far as packing goes, would be much more simple. This has some weird lines like this 45 here towards the corners that you gotta do. That's a little tough to figure out at first. They don't explain that well. But once you get doing it and see how the lines used to be in it, you can do it. So we're to this point. All right, well, there it is. Gonna repack it and reinstall it, and it went pretty good. I am highly confident, I guess. No, I am.
This is a 140, if I don't know if I mentioned that. So it's good size. This thing's got a lot of Velcro. Got a top Velcro, a bottom Velcro. It's got 4 corners that flip under these tabs. Very secure handle, which is nice for accidental deployment. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this part of my journey. One more thing done. Just gotta install it. That's it. See you guys.
Back on. Hey, is this, you guys mention in the comments what you think. Am I just paranoid, but I don't like to hook the metal, even though it's got a little rubber on it, that's pretty worn, onto metal, but I put a little rope loop between the two. Overkill or not. All right, see you guys later.